disgraceful. Leftist judge starts laughing during DT hearing in New York City as crazy Letitia James glares at DT. Yeah, this is happening right now. This is not a broadcasted hearing, and that's why we're not airing it right now. But yeah, this is a screenshot of her staring and laughing. Okay, we got the judge laughing right here. He is in court today. He has arrived. He is there. Yeah, DT spent the weekend campaigning in front of massive crowds in California and Iowa. On Monday, he flew to New York City, where he was called to court in another junk lawsuit hurled at him by Democrats. During a hearing this morning in the Democrats continued lawfare assault against the leading candidate in the 2024 selection, Judge Arthur Engoron started laughing. This tells you everything you need to know about this kangaroo court. This is a $250 million civil suit here, okay? Which he will lose, and he'll have to win in the appellate courts or in the Supreme Courts. Because look at the crooked judge that got stacked up against this guy. I'm telling you, DT, if you win next year, if you win and you do not clean the swamp, expect Barron to go through the same thing. You should have did martial law. We were all ready for it. You should have did it. This is reprehensible. These people are lawless and wicked. Watch the major media outlets ignore and refuse to report this till today. Liz Harrington writes, the judge is laughing. Absolutely disgusting. This commie will be overturned. Crazy Letitia James sat staring at DT. Chuck Castillo writes, this image coupled with the judge smiling and laughing for the cameras pre-trial should tell you everything you need to know about this case against DT. And don't forget, this is the same judge that allowed cameras in the courtroom. What a farce. For the record, DT released a list of facts surrounding this garbage lawsuit earlier today. Letitia James is a Soros-funded Democrat attorney general. Bagface George provided funding for Letitia James's campaign. James also received funding from Bagface George's daughter-in-law, Jennifer Soros. Letitia James made clear that getting DT was the motivating force behind her campaign for attorney general. In a 2018 video, Letitia stated, I'm running for attorney general because I will never be afraid to challenge the illegitimate president when our fundamental rights are at stake. He should be charged with obstructing justice. I believe that the president in this U.S. can be indicted for criminal offenses, and we would join the law enforcement and other attorneys generals across the nation in removing this president from office. It is important that everyone understand that the days of DT are coming to an end. That is a quote from Letitia James in 2018. Letitia James announced that as attorney general, she looked forward to going into the office of AG every day, suing DT, and then going home. During her 2018 campaign, Letitia James vowed, in quotes, as the next attorney general of New York, I will be a voice for the powerless and take on DT. James said, in quotes, the president of the U.S. has to worry about three things. Mueller, Cohen, and Trish James. We're all closing in on him. That is what she said. She also admitted that her desire to take down DT more than helping the people of New York motivated her run for attorney general. Letitia James in 2018 said, this campaign was never really about me or any of the candidates who ran. This is a quote. It was about the people, but mostly it was about the man in the White House who can't go a day without threatening our fundamental rights. She says. When she won in 2018, Letitia James reiterated her intention to use the power of her office to target DT. She says, in quotes, I will be a shining bright light into every dark corner of his real estate dealings and every dealing demanding truthfulness at every turn. Remember, this is the one where that's about a misentry in the journal, like the accounting journal, okay? That is not DT's job, okay? This would be like prosecuting Jeff Bezos. Because an accountant did something wrong, okay? You're not supposed to. You don't prosecute the CEO. You prosecute the director of accounting or the vice president of finance. That's who you get. They're the ones you sign off on at the very end, okay? You don't go after the owner of the company. Anyways, Letitia also says, "Here's what DT needs to know. We've got my eyes on DT Tower." Letitia called DT an embarrassment to all that we stand for. She also promised to be a force pushing back against DT through legal challenges. Letitia highlighted, so I'm telling you guys, after if DT takes power, okay, there I better see a political persecution restitution act. Okay, $1 million for everyone who has been put away for J6, and obviously he's gonna have to be reimbursed for all these legal fees, right? Exactly, that needs to happen. A former attorney, senior FBI, Leticia is a Democrat activist. During each of her last 2 years, Leticia contributed to ActBlue, a left-wing online fundraising platform that JB and many other Democrat candidates used in 2020 and 2016, actually. Leticia James has donated to multiple Democrat candidates. Leticia James has been soft on crime and has tried to prevent New York police officers from doing their jobs. Last year, Leticia refused to commit to tightening New York's no cash bail system, which is now going strong in Los Angeles. Good luck out there. I told you all to leave. Saying we need to make sure we are resisting the urge to overreact to spikes in crime, she says. And to that I say, why are people not paying these people who are being let out on $0 bail to go after people? I mean, they are, but the problem is it's only the Democrats doing it. Leticia James recommended that police officers stop detaining people with certain open warrants during traffic stops because the involvement of police in such situations can result in violent interactions. Yeah, there was an incident out in New Jersey where a councilwoman, a black woman, GOP, patriot, was taken out randomly. Okay, a guy just went pow, 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 and she's gone. Yeah. She's a rising star too, black woman. Would have done well, unfortunately put down by other blacks. In 2021, Leticia James introduced a bill to limit police officers' use of force and make it easier to prosecute officers. Yeah, so she's a total Marxist DA. Everything she's done is bad. Let's see, she also covered for her former chief of staff who was accused of naughty harassment. She also used taxpayer dollars to fund her radical woke agenda. She also has pursued an anti-Second Amendment agenda, which is not constitutional, by the way. All the restrictions that New York's passing is not constitutional at all. Crime in New York has skyrocketed under her watch. Yeah, very true. Yeah, we're going to run over the stats in another video. Yeah, anyways, awful, guys. What's going on?